So today I want to make an analysis of an article on Vox, that is Vox self-policy portal that has been written by Jesper Linde and Matthias Trabant on the 12th November 2019, and is entitled "Resolving the Missing Deflation and Inflation Puzzles." This is an article in which the two authors try to analyze why the Phillips curve doesn't apply anymore, neither in recession, neither in the economic recovery. In effect, the authors report some economic fact, that is the fact, for example, that in the US, during the Great Recession, the GDP declines of about 10%, while the inflation dropped only by 1.5%. So there was no deflation during this recession, as instead the Phillips curve would have presumed. And they report a quotation from the New York Fed president John C. Williams, that wrote, "The surprise is that it's fallen so little, given the depth and duration of the recent downturn. Based on the experience of past several recessions, I would have expected inflation to fall by twice as much as it has." So not to a drop by of 1.5%, but a drop by 3%. And this was not happening. So the authors continues the article, noting that also in recovery there is no sufficient inflation, and so this led the authors to understand that probably there is a rigidity in price and wage determination, and so they suggest their solution is the suggestion of the fact that economists should not use any more linear models, but non-linear models that are based on the Kimball aggregator that substitutes the Dixit-Stiglitz aggregator. And so by using Kimball aggregator and by non-linear models, these economists are able to estimate better the missing relation between GDP changes and inflation or deflation response. And so they re-estimate models. They found that the new Phillips curve that is based on this rigidity of prices using this kind of Kimball aggregator has a shape of banana. They speak about this banana shape of Phillips curve. And so they find this solution. They conclude their article, saying that there are real rigidities in prices that generate a lower response of inflation and deflation in respect to GDP growth and GDP declines. But at the same time, there is also a technical question, that is the use of the aggregator, the use of Kimball aggregator. So for the solution for the authors is the fact that economists should use is the fact that we should reject linear models and apply non-linear models based on new Keynesian economic theory. This is the solution that this economist propose. What I can say about this article, this is an article that is only a that is a classic article of mainstream. The authors, that are Jesper Linde and Matthias Trabant, they miss completely to analyze, for example, the institutional approach to crisis and in the phase of recovery of a crisis. We know that institutions that are, for example, central banks and governments are not neutral in respect to recovery and are not neutral also in respect of crisis. So these economists, they don't understand the fact that the missing Phillips curve is based effectively on a change in the institutional policy that is based either on a government political fiscal policy and either on central bank political politics, because government are not, for example, there are during the late crisis of 2010, many governments were not in the position to sustain their own economy due to the presence of high level of debt, of public debt. And this is not a price rigidity, is not a wage rigidity. This is an institutional rigidity that imply the impossibility to generate that kind of recovery that, for example, after a crisis can generate inflation in respect of an increase in GDP. And also the central banks have more rigidity. For example, in the case of European central banks, there are a lot of rigidity. Even if president of the European Central Bank, even if they trigger the bazooka, they are not able to give money to people or firms. They just can give money to other banks. The central banks give money to banks, and banks are, if there is a crisis, they use money to recover their own balance sheet condition, and they don't give money to families or firms. So there are rigidities that are not price of wage rigidities. These are institutional rigidities that are based on financial elements that are, for example, that are based on public debt in the case of the state, but are based also on rigidity in the production, in the distribution of money supply in the case of the central bank system. So these are conditions that certainly reduce the linear response of inflation and respect to change in GDP growth. But at the same time, we have to say that if we don't understand the role of institution, and in this sense we have to recall the importance of Douglas North and this institutional neo-institutional theory, if we don't understand the role of institution in price determination, in determination of inflation, in determination of also deflation during the recession, we are not able to estimate the recovery, never to predict the recovery in the inflation during the recovery. So it is good that non-linear. So it is for this reason that we have to reject linear models, and we have to apply non-linear models. But this is only a methodological question. If we try to put in the linear models also an institutional variable, also if we are applied to estimate in a linear model what are the rigidity that are introduced by institution, we have not to abandon the linear model to a non-linear model. We can remain in the linear model, but probably we have to adjust the model considering other variables that generates effectively more rigidity in the mechanism of wage and price determination. So the solution of the authors is a methodological solution that we can obviously accept, but that is on the point of view of economic theory is insufficient. The policymaker needs to know what to do. Financiers and also stakeholders and also economic operators have to know how to manage crisis and what are the effects of a GDP growth And by doing this, we have to introduce some kind of complexity in the linear model to generate, continue to generate description that can be able to consider why Jean Prey's determination. So by this this is the missing variable in this article. We have to reject only methodological approach. We have to reject only metrics. If these metrics, even if they give a sense to data, they don't have economic sense. They don't have the ability to explain what is happening in the economic institution. And we have to understand that only an institutionalist approach, especially if we want to understand inflation, because inflation is the topic of central bank. If we want to understand inflation, we have to put in the equation also the institutional variable. And this can save, in a certain sense, linear models from being completely rejected, and in a certain sense can also save by an institutional approach also the mainstream economic theory.